Hi guys, in this video we will discuss enterprise project structure, what is EPS and how to create EPS in Primavera P6. Guys, this is Mutasar Malik. I am professional trainer of Oracle Primavera P6 and Microsoft Project Professional. So hierarchical structure that identifies the company-wide projects and enables organizing and management of those projects. Your P6 projects are arranged in a hierarchically called the enterprise project structure or EPS. The EPS can be subdivided into as many levels or nodes as needed to parallel work at your organization. We can divide in departments, project phases, site locations, or other major groupings that meet the needs of your organization. Projects always represent the lowest level of the hierarchy. Every project must be included in an EPS node. When you create a project, you must specify a single parent EPS node. Actually, it's showing your line of business. The EPS is laid out in a tree structure. EPS can be created up to 50 levels. Maximum character length for an EPS ID is 20, and for EPS description are 100. So let's jump to the P6 file, how to create EPS. So when you will add EPS, create new EPS, let's open first P6. So when you will open, you need to enter your login name and password. So my password is same, then click on connect. So when our software is opened, so now software is open. So let's start. Now software is opened. So we will use path how to create EPS. Go to enterprise, then enterprise project structure. So here, guys, you will add your company ID and your company name first. So ID should be like Descon, and name is Descon Engineering. Okay, so then add from this button a plus symbol, and you can see here, click on add, and now you can see it is subcategory of company. Actually, Descon work in major three areas like engineering, procurement, and construction. So let's add here engineering first, E and double C. Engineering, and the second one is procurement, and last one is construction. So guys, you need to add in left side column, you need to add here EPS ID, and in right side EPS name, you need to add here a description and full name. Suppose for engineering, we will add their EPS ID like E and double G. For construction, we add here E and CONST construction. Okay, so this is the way you can add your EPS in Primavera P6. And let me add furthermore their subcategories. We can divide into further categories like add. And you can see it is showing parallel of construction. I want to make it indent of construction. So I will select this this row and click on right arrow key. So shift it right. So when you will shift it right, you can see it is now indent of construction. So now I will add here their further category. Suppose In construction, we have a main two categories like buildings and construction of buildings project. Projects, and second one is roads construction of roads project. Road projects. So then add, and the last one is bridges. So you can add similar construction of projects. So this is the way how you can add subcategories. If you want to make it outdone, if you want to make parallel of construction, so you can select construction of bridges and shift it left. So now you can see it is outdone. It is parallel with construction. Okay. If you want to make indent, then shift it right. If you want to change their place, suppose you want to shift it up, then click on up arrow key. Shift it up. You can see it is working. So then shift it down in last. Okay. So if you want to make break down there further in further tasks, then add and shift it right. Here we can add suppose COMM commercial buildings, and second one is RES residential buildings. Okay, so this is the way how you can add your EPS. These four buttons you can use for indent or outdent or up or change their places, up shift, down shift. Okay, so you can, if you want to see it in chart view, then go to display, click on display, then click on chart view. So now you can see it is showing in chart view. So it is showing in vertical view. If you want to change it in horizontal view, then click on parents of account, again go to display, click on arrange return, and click on horizontal. So now you can see it is showing in horizontal view. If you want to print it, then click on display, then click on print preview. So now you can see it is showing in print preview window. You can make a change in header or footer, and then you can print it. Then close. And again, if you want to change this box color, or you can make formatting, and you can add some more text, or you can you want to hide some text from box, then click on display and chart box template, so you can amend it. Again, display and chart box font color, so you can change their font color, box color from here. Suppose box color should be like this. Apply, and you can see your box color changed. So you can change their font color. Sorry, this is background color, your chart box background color. So you can change from here. Okay, you can see. And now I want to change font color. Click on font and click on bold. And I want to change their color. I want to make it black. And click on OK and apply. Now you can see your color, font color also changed. And click on OK. Okay, now again click on display and you can print it, so it will show show you like this. So you can see this is the view, how you can print it, then close and again click on display and click on table view. So this is the way, guys, how you can create EPS in Primavera P6. So this is I have started this series. So please like this video and share it with your friends, my colleagues, or also subscribe my channel for upcoming videos. Thank you very much.